The 100 square miles of the Black Hills were just peppered with these little small towns. Most have been pretty much vanished. If you went out there in the summers, you'd be hard-pressed to find many ruins. Trojan was about 6 miles out of Lead to the west by the ski slopes, right on the edge of Terry Peak. Major mining area, it was called the Ruby Basin, which was a conglomerate of many mines. It was a small metropolitan area. Trojan itself was originally known as Portland. Portland became the Trojan Mining Company, and then I think it was about in the 19-teens when it became the Bald Mountain Mining Company. It was a town with its businesses, grocery stores. It had its own school, which was the last building demolished. They didn't demolish that until 2010. No, it was a major town, right up there with Lead and Deadwood. It was a railroad center, not only for the Black Hills railroads, like the Burlington and the Chicago Northwestern, but there was spurs off of those that went out to some of these smaller towns and smaller mines that have since disappeared. And then the mine itself had quite a system of rails. But it was a major producer right up there with Homestake up until 1959. Right after it closed, there was some businessmen from Milwaukee, Wisconsin that wanted to build a tourist resort up there. And they actually did get a start with it. Going back to railroads, they took trains to two different sites full of tourists. I was one of those tourists and just thought that was the greatest thing in the world. They were calling it the Top of the Hills. And at one point, they were trying to evict any of the residents that were left because they wanted all the buildings that were any good to be used in their resort plans. But it was major plans. It only lasted about 2 years. And at that time, the town was pretty much vacant. The next inhabitants of the town of Trojan were migrants from eastern South Dakota. Many of the young folks that came out to the Black Hills from the Sioux Falls and surrounding area ended up settling in Trojan. It was the revival. It really truly was the revival of Trojan. It was thriving with all these young folks. They had bands up there. I think Red Willow was up there, Jack Kreitzer. Yeah, in the 60s and the 70s in particular, it was quite thriving with all these young folks. But the first time I found it, I kind of came in the back door. We were out running around the woods, and I had no idea really where I was. And all of a sudden, we came around the curve on this railroad grade, and here was this big, huge mill that I'd been to as a little kid when they tried to make this tourist thing. But I just kind of accidentally stumbled on it and thought, oh, wow. This is great, and then I started, after that, going up there fairly often. It was quite a place. I used to love to four-wheel drive up there. There was another mine that was first part of Wharf that they mined. It was called the Reliance Mine, and I loved prowling around in these mines. It was just a great place to explore. A lot of history, a lot of artifacts, and it was all still there. You could go up and touch it. Take pictures of it, take people there and show it to them, but it's all gone. It's a rock pile. It's pretty much all buried underneath the Wharf waste rock. And so if you're interested, you can discover a lot of fascinating history. And unless you're really interested in the history, a lot of it will just disappear because the people don't know.